So many of you might have known that I've been on a crazy search for the perfect camera, and the first one I got was the Hero 4. The Hero 4 is a nice camera, it's a good camera, it's got great features, but there's a cost barrier. These things are expensive, right? For the newest, latest, greatest one, they're just expensive. So I instantly just jumped from the Hero 4 to a cheap Chinese type made camera. Very inexpensive, but they have their drawbacks. The batteries don't last. It's just kind of junk most of the times. So then I'm like, well, let's go with a mid-range camera from the GoPro lineup. But the big thing there is that it doesn't have the features that I really wanted in a action cam. Still a good camera. It's very small, so you can put it in a bunch of places. But it just doesn't have things like the mic input. So I was like, I want a small camera that has the mic input. Maybe I should get this little guy. This is a lipstick or tube type camera. It's made for motorcycle riders majority of times. It's a nice camera. It's, like I said, pretty easy. You just flick that button, you're ready to go. I like this camera a lot, but again, it just doesn't have the functionality. Additionally, it doesn't have the mounts. And it's got a really weird plug, if you saw that little red plug for the mic input. So now it comes to the Ghost X by Drift. It's got some really cool features. So it's got HD, it's got stability. This is a really cool one where the lens actually can move independently of the body. The battery life is extremely long on here. Comes with all your goodies. Quick guide, of course, reset tool, charger, all the stuff that you would kind of find in most other camera packages. It does the full 1080p. It does live streaming. It's got a ton of different video modes and frame rates for those who are interested in that. I just, to be honest with you, chalk it up to the highest one and go. The battery is a 2000 milliamp battery, and it can take up to 128 gig card. It also has wireless. It's a pretty mean green camera, although it's black. So let's take it out of the wrapping here, and we'll give you a look at what the actual camera is like. It's extremely small, as you can see, which that's one of my things. I was looking for a small camera. The battery life is amazing on this. I have charged the battery, but I don't even know. I think like 5 hours. It's ridiculous the amount of battery that is actually on here. I noticed that this kind of looked weird, so I just kind of put it aside there, but that was actually the mount. The instruction booklet is humongous. Even comes with stickers, which are pretty cool. I think I might even put that on my plane. Comes with two of them and a neat little box for those who are interested in, well, boxes. Super excited about this camera. So far, I've been playing around with it, and it's given me everything that I've needed. So, a little bit more in the packaging there. So there we go, drop it out of the box there, hard with one hand. And it comes with some standard stuff and not so standard stuff. So here we go, we've got the link cable, which I love this because it allows you, I'll show you in a second, to record your audio. The charging cable, pretty standard. Two mounts. The first one is a flat mount, which is exactly what I said, a flat mount, and the other one's a curved mount, so that's interesting. And then your reset tool, and then it comes with the little adapter that fits to the camera. And then the way that it works is you just kind of link it into your mount, so it's easy to change the different mounts that come with it. I'll show you in just a few minutes that you can also get a optional GoPro style mount, so it'll attach to all the GoPros. Window is very small on here, however I didn't really notice anything too crazy. I wasn't straining my eyes or anything. I knew when the thing was on and off, and when I hit record it turned red, so easy enough. SD card slot, pretty standard. And then your USB charging port, and then also that acts as your microphone in, which is pretty cool. The mount ring The top three buttons, pretty easy. And then this is the coolest thing. Well, I don't know if it's the coolest thing, but it's definitely a cool feature. It has the ability to turn the entire lens without it turning the body of the camera, and you can almost get 360 out of this. meaning that you can get almost a 360 turn, which is pretty awesome. How do I know it's on? Well, I push the on button and it turns green. Another feature that I absolutely love about these cameras is the ability to just know when it's working. So A, I know when it's on, and B, I know when it's recording. I know it's on because it lights up green. The LCD screen is on, and I know when it's recording because it turns red. So this is the little mount. It's pretty easy. You can use your fingers actually to tighten the connection there. So how you connect it is pretty standard. You just select it through the Wi-Fi there, open up the application, and then you're connected to the actual application. So it does everything for you. And through this app, it's pretty wild because you have the ability to do every single thing on the camera through your phone. So if this was in your plane, you don't even have to touch the camera. You just work everything through your app. It does the settings as well. If it's outside of your plane, hanging on an exterior mount or something to that effect, if you have like a Rocksteady mount or whatnot. By the way, I'm doing a full review on the Rocksteady mounts. I can put the link in here. Then you have the ability to turn the camera on, off, adjust your settings. You can do it on the fly, which is pretty outstanding. So the app itself is very simple. It's simple to use, just like the camera. However, in its simplicity, it makes it even better. I just absolutely love this camera. It's amazing. Like I said, I've tried all different types of cameras, and this one's probably the best yet. The clarity, the picture, it's beautiful, and it provides all the features that I would ever want in a camera.
One of the features that this camera has is the ability to record the radio traffic. So it comes with an adapter that plugs right into your headset. Also, you can get different adapters to plug right into your intercom jack. But the best thing about this is you have record of what was said over the radio. That way, for training, you can always review your flights and kind of see what you tripped up on. If there's too many uhs or ums over the radio, you have record of that. And it's just kind of a nice way to review your flight. Also, if you hear anything interesting over the radio, you have record of that as well. So it's a key feature in an aviation-type camera. If you're wanting to keep records, if you're serious about aviation, this is probably the best way to do it.
So if you haven't noticed by this video, this is probably the favorite camera out of all of my cameras in my collection. I think this is going to be either on board or on my plane every time I go flying now. It's just nice to have a camera with you to, of course, capture the video and then capture your audio. So this camera was $129. I bought it myself. Not affiliated with Drift, but if you want to pick one up since we're nearing Black Friday, you might be able to get a deal within the next few days. This pairs very well up with the Rocksteady mounts that I'm going to do a review. I will post the link in this video for that Rocksteady mount review. And that's pretty much it for today. I appreciate you guys staying around. Have a happy Thanksgiving. Have fun out there, stay safe, and of course, always stay thrifty. Have a good one. See ya.